everyone. Welcome to the program. I'm Takashi Gojobori. Here is one of the authors, Professor Robert Hohendorf. So mouse clinics, it sounds very interesting. Could you tell us the purpose of these people?
So mouse clinics is actually quite a well-chosen name. This paper mainly discusses how to perform this testing and how to standardize between many different clinics because it's a major undertaking. There is the International Mouse Phenotyping Consortium. They try to agree on common standards to standardize their tests. The aim of this consortium is to deactivate every single function-bearing gene in the mouse and determine what the phenotypes are. So there are 20,000 genes which have to be deactivated one by one. And they tested this on, I think, a bit over 400 alleles, encoding a bit less than 400 genes.
I see. So what's the significance of this paper, particularly in disease, human health?
Yes, of course. Well, many of the diseases we get have a genetic basis. And some of our genes break, and suddenly we get diseases like diabetes. And the same thing happens in mice. Only in mice or in other animals, we have some control over which genes break. And they allow us to gain some insight in human disease and how we can treat them.
I understand that the mouse has more than 20,000 genes. So you did it gene by gene for those mice?
For about 360 genes, we deactivated one by one of these genes. And this is only the start. So for this to have sufficient statistical power, we had to use over 27,000 mice. This is for about 360, a bit under 400 genes. The goal of this and the goal of the International Mouse Phenotyping Consortium is to do this for every single function-bearing gene in the mouse. So for 20,000 different genes, individually for a set of mice, we're going to deactivate them and then we observe what happens.
I see. This is a kind of a first step of your, you know, consortium research.
Yes.
Okay, Robert, what did you find?
We found it's very hard.
Okay.
Just like for humans.
Right.
It's difficult. If you take one hospital and you go to the next, there may be small differences in procedure. If you want to compare blood pressure between one hospital and the next, well, was it taken while standing, after rest, and so on. And these tiny little differences get very difficult to compare and to reproduce the results. And especially we try to come up with a set of standardized tests, just like we do for humans, so that we can compare and that we have people from all over Europe, US, Japan involved in this program, so that we can all work together towards this goal of finding out what are the phenotypes, signs and symptoms when we deactivate one of these 20,000 genes. We have developed standard operating procedures, done a lot of analysis on the statistics, and we have controlled vocabularies we can share across different clinics.
So in this paper, you set up those standardizations to
yes.
conduct such a huge analysis.
Yes.
And what would be the impact?
I think there are two impacts. So with over 100 authors, we have established the baselines for phenotyping mice, which we can now use in other clinics. We can basically scale up the project to come closer to our goal of 20,000 genes. The second one is we have shown that from these tests, we can directly screen for human diseases just by looking at the mouse. So there's a clear impact directly on human health.
So you think this paper would be very useful not only for mouse clinics, but human clinics too?
There is still much to be done before we get the direct impact. But this is the first work. And once we scale this up and transfer it to human, we have an incredible resource for human health.
That's great. And good luck. Thanks so much, Robert.
Oh, thank you.